My name's Rick Schuller. I'm the district ranger on the Evanston and Mountain View Ranger District of the UNO Wasatch Cache National Forest. All the beetle kill on the north slope. We started actually in the 80s with the first hit, mainly got the east side of the district, and then we proceeded to the big epidemic that started 12, 15 years ago with mountain pine beetle first, and then the spruce beetle came in behind that. And so we've taken a real hit. We're 80 to 90% dead on the north slope on the Evanston Mountain View Ranger District right now.
Because of the pine beetle epidemic and because of all the dead trees on the ground and all the standing dead, we are likely to have an uncharacteristic fire in the area. As fire managers, we use the term fuel a lot. This just means vegetation, whether it's trees, shrubs, grasses. So when we say fuel loading is really high, it means that there's a lot of dead and down, or the shrubs are really close to each other. And this can create an uncharacteristic fire for the area.
So as far as effects to the forest and for the recreating public and the rest of our users, where people camp, where they park, where they recreate, where they do all the things they want to do out there has really been affected by that amount of dead fuel. So we have a lot of problems keeping our trails open. Most of our trail crews have to cut their way into an area and then cut their way back out because we get that much downfall now.
For years, we've suppressed fire. The area needs it. The aspen need it, the wildlife need it. It's a key player in the ecosystem. It's a key player because it's natural. The trees get so overgrown, they die, and then there's no place for the wildlife to be. So it's nature's way of cleaning up the forest. And so it doesn't do it in one big burn. She'll do it in small patches, creating these mosaic openings. So we're coming back and replicating Mother Nature to try to get the area back to a healthy stand or a healthy ecosystem.
By doing these things, we want to mimic nature, but speed it up a little bit. So we're opening up the trails. We're gonna burn some of those areas off, reduce the hazardous fuel so it's not a hazard as people come out. They don't have to worry about crossing dead trees all the time, which is what they have to worry about now. Some areas you can't ride a horse through because it's so thick with dead and down. We have a lot of different kinds of things going on out there. We're cutting, thinning, hand piling out there along the trails and roadways. We're doing mastication in bigger areas where we've got regen and older standing pines and spruce out there. So we got a lot of different things happening, all in an effort to basically jumpstart Mother Nature in the restoration process of the area.
We're trying not to have the tops of trees touch each other. That way, if a fire were to get in the area, it wouldn't get into the tops of the trees and jump from tree to tree. So this gives fire managers options for when a fire does happen into the area. But the benefit of us doing a prescribed fire is that it's on our terms. And so we have more control. It's safer for our firefighters. It's safer for the public. We burn on days that the air quality is really good. And that is beneficial for the community, that way they're not having smoke settle in. Whereas if we get a wildfire in the area, we have no control on how much smoke is being put up. Whereas fire managers, we can mitigate that a lot easier on a prescribed fire.